Hello friends, today we're going to explore and animate the PowerPoint slide that show the places in the circular motion using the Morph transition like this. So the first thing, you have to have the image or icon or any icon that have a transparency background, some kind of like this. For example, I have the four places and I have changed the background color like this so that you can see there is no the background on each icon or each image places that you have. Okay, so the first you go to insert and then choose the circle shape and draw it by holding the shift key so that the circle will be perfectly circle. Okay, and then you're gonna change the transparency so that you can see the background of the slide like this. Okay, and then you're gonna send it back so that the icon or image is placed in front of the circle like this. So I'm going to resize the image so that you can see it's bigger enough in each screen like that. Okay, or you can minimize or just resize what you want like that. So for the first place, I'm going to move the Eiffel Tower to the middle like this, to the center one, and then I'm going to do on the Pisa Tower as well. So we just rotate it into the right corner like that, and then we're going to do on the Angkor Wat Temple to rotate into next to the Tower Eiffel. Okay, and then for the last one, this is for Bayon Temple. We just rotate the head of the temple, just go to outside like that, so that when we remove the motion in the circular, it's gonna be show in the slide. So just do it like that, and you make sure that the shape of the image must be in the circle. Okay, we have a match space that don't have the building or have the temple, so we can show the empty space when the first initiate the slide animation. Okay, and then press Ctrl A to select all the elements so that we can move all the elements into the middle of the slide presentation. Okay, and I think it should be shown like that. You can see on the left side is the tower is in the middle. Okay, then we have to group all the elements together so that you can see we can move the circle into the middle point like that. Okay, it have some point that hide in the elements of the image, so you can move it so that you can see it fit perfectly. You can do it or resize it to the fit to the screen like that. Okay, you can move that, but make sure the shape of the image must be in the circle. Okay, I'm going to rotate it so it's gonna be perfectly vertical. Start do rotation more. Okay, for this Pisa Tower is just a little bit go to top, and I have to resize it to the big one. You can see at the left side is the full screen of the slide presentation. Okay, now I think it's perfect. Now we have done on the first layer, we just do only the image rotation. So then we're going to do another layer. The second layer is for the text. The text is referred to the title of the image. So for example, we can put the to Eiffel Tower, the text like that. And before we do that, we're going to add the shadow to the image so that we can see it is gonna be pop up from the background. So we have to copy the circle. We're just going to click on that. The first click is going to be select the grouping, and then the second click is going to be select the circle one. So then we can copy it by Ctrl C and Ctrl V. You can see that we can copy it out. Now I'm going to change the color so that we can see it's different, and you have to bring it into the front, the first layer. It means that it overlap on the layer, the last layer that we have designed. Okay, so we have to do its overlap like this, So then we're going to do on the text. So go to insert, to the work art. And we're going to write a text for each building like that. I'm going to fill the color as the white color, and we're going to remove the outline as well. And for the font, we can change whatever you want. You love with it, you can do it. Just change it to the font that you like. After you love with the result, you can move the font next to the building like that. And I'm going to add the effects as well, the shadow effects. I'm going to select this top one, okay, so that we can see the text is going to be jump out from the background, okay. Okay, I think I love with this result, so I'm going to copy this text by just holding Ctrl and then select all the text that you want to copy and move it to another the building next to another building like that. Just rotate this to match to the building. For the animation, the image of the building is going to be rotate counterclockwise, but for the name of the building is going to be rotate into the clockwise. So the animation is must be the tag is different from the building for the first initiate. Okay, after you place the name of each building already, and then we have to select each name of the building like that. And select the circle one, the layer. And then we have to group this layer together, okay? So then it's combined into one layer or one element. So that you can see, I can drag it, move together like that, okay? And then now this time we're going to remove the fill, background, and the outlines of the circle, okay? You can see, now we have no one layer, the under layer for the image, there has no background. And for this layer, we're going to do the same. We just refill with snow fill and the outline as well. And you can see we can rotate it because of the pivot point of the circle is in the center. Okay, and this because of the name of the building is placed in incorrect order for animate. So I have to edit and rename the title again. Because of the animate rotation for the image or for the building is going to be rotated into the counterclockwise. But for the name of the title, we have to. Rotate into the clockwise rotation. So we have to change it, the name it again. Now I think it's fine, it's going to be rotated. So now we're going to duplicate the slide like this. We have to duplicate the slide, and the first move we're going to move counterclockwise for the image. Like that for the center, you can see. And then for the title, we're going to rotate into the clockwise like this. And you can see we can duplicate it more for move to the same rotation, okay, for the next for the Bayon temple like that, and we rotate counterclockwise, okay, another one. And move the text next to the building like that, But this is the last line. I'm confusing where the direction should be rotated, so I have to check it again like that. And then we're gonna move it to the Eiffel Tower, okay? And for the text, we gotta move to the Eiffel Tower. Okay, let's check. I have done apply the transition yet. For each slide, it have none like that, you can see. And then for the next, I'm going to change the format background color so that we can see it's more fancy and more attractive. Okay, now each slide have different color. So now we're going to apply the transition. For the first slide, we don't have to apply the transition, but for the rest, we have to apply the morph transition. Okay, now the final result, let's see. Each transition, you can change the duration as well. So you can find the link in the description for download this template. And if you love this kind of content, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe for more design tips and resources. And see you guys in the next tutorial. Goodbye.